Hello viewers, welcome to our channel. Today we are going to start class 8 science chapter number 4, that is materials, metals and non-metals. Question number 1 is which of the following can be beaten into thin sheets? The options are zinc, phosphorus, sulfur, oxygen. The correct answer is zinc because zinc is a metal and it can be beaten into thin sheets, whereas rest of the three are non-metals. Question number 2 is which of the following statement is correct? All metals are ductile. This statement is wrong because there is an exceptional case, that is mercury, which is a metal and it is in the liquid state at room temperature. Second part is all non-metals are ductile. This statement is wrong because it is not the property of non-metal. Third part is generally metals are ductile. This statement is true because metals, they can be drawn into wires. Last one is some non-metals are ductile. As I have already told you that it is not the property of non-metal. Question number 3 is filling the blanks. Phosphorus is very reactive non-metal. Because when it is exposed to air, it catches fire and we have to store it in the water. The next one is metals are dash conductors of heat and dash. So metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Metals jo hain ye heat aur electricity ko pass hone dete hain. So that's why they are good conductors of heat and electricity. Iron is dash reactive than copper. So iron is more reactive than copper. Metals react with acids to produce hydrogen gas. Question number 4 is true and false. Generally, non-metals react with acids. Answer is false because metals react with acids. Sodium is a very reactive metal, so this is a true statement. Copper displaces zinc from zinc sulfate solution. This is a false statement because copper is less reactive than the zinc. Coal can be drawn into wires because coal is a non-metal and we cannot draw wires from the coal. So, question number 5 is some properties are listed in the following table. Distinguish between metals and non-metals on the basis of these properties. So first one is appearance. So metals, they are lustrous, they are shiny, whereas non-metals, they are dull. Second one is hardness. Metals are hard except sodium and potassium, whereas non-metals are soft except diamond. Malleability, metals can be beaten into thin sheets, whereas non-metals cannot be beaten into thin sheets. Ductility, metals can be drawn into wires, whereas non-metals cannot be drawn into wires. Heat conduction, metals, they are good conductors of heat, whereas non-metals are poor conductors of heat. Conduction of electricity, metals are good conductors of electricity, whereas non-metals are poor conductors of electricity. Question number 6 is, give reasons for the following. Aluminium foils are used to wrap food items because they are malleable and can be beaten into thin foils as aluminium is a metal. Second one is immersion rods for heating liquids are made up of metallic substances because metals are good conductors of heat and they allow the heat to pass through it. Copper cannot displace zinc from its salt solution because zinc is more reactive than copper and more reactive metal cannot replace the less reactive metal. Sodium and potassium are stored in kerosene because they are highly reactive elements. They easily catch fire when comes in contact with air and water. It reacts vigorously with oxygen and water and produce large amount of heat. Question number 7 is, can you store lemon pickle in aluminium utensil? Explain. No, we cannot store lemon pickle in aluminium utensil because it is an acid and will react with lemon pickle, because lemon has a citric acid and it will react with the aluminium metal, so your pickle will get spoiled in it. Question number 8 is, match the substances with their uses. Correct answers we have mentioned over here. Gold, that is jewelry. Iron is used in machinery. Aluminium, that is for wrapping food. Carbon, we use it as a fuel. Copper, that is used in the electric wires. And mercury, that is used in the thermometers. Question number 9 is, what happens when dilute sulfuric acid is poured on a copper plate? When dilute sulfuric acid is poured on a copper plate, the metal does not react with sulfuric acid. But when concentrated sulfuric acid is poured over the copper plate, it liberates hydrogen gas. That means it releases the hydrogen gas. The chemical reaction we have given you below, that is copper, the chemical name is Cu plus sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4, that gives out copper sulfate plus hydrogen gas. The next one is, iron nails are placed in copper sulfate solution. Iron, being more reactive, displaces copper from its salt solution. Blue color will fade away and light green color will be formed due to formation of iron sulfate. Reddish brown deposit of copper on iron nail can be seen. Here is the chemical reaction we have given. That is, iron plus copper sulfate gives rise to iron sulfate and copper. The copper sulfate is blue and it has turned to green, and iron has taken place of copper, and copper has been separated from the copper sulfate. The next question is, Saloni took a piece of burning charcoal and collected the gas evolved in a test tube. First part is, how will she find the nature of the gas? The answer to this is, she will add a few drops of water in a test tube in which she has collected the gas collected from the charcoal and shake it. After shaking the solution, test the solution with the blue and red litmus. If the solution turns blue litmus red, the gas is acidic in nature. Question part B is, write down word equations of all the reactions taking place in the process. The answer is, charcoal reacts with oxygen to form carbon dioxide gas. Carbon we get from the charcoal, that is C, plus oxygen, that gives out carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide reacts with H2O water to form carbonic acid, which turns blue litmus red, that is, it is acidic. The chemical formula is, carbon dioxide plus water gives you H2CO3. The next one is, one day Rita went to jeweler's shop with her mother. Her mother gave an old gold jewelry to the goldsmith to polish. Next day, when they bought the jewelry back, they found that there was a slight loss in its weight. Can you suggest a reason for the loss in weight? The answer is, to polish a gold ornament, it is dipped in a liquid called aqua regia, a mixture of hydrochloric acid and nitric acid. The outer layer of gold dissolves and the inner shiny layer appears. The dissolving of the layer causes a reduction in the weight of the jewelry. Do subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching. Have a great day ahead. Bye bye.